one of the arguments we hear coming from the new type of atheist. When I was a child, I believed in Santa Claus. When I was a child, I believed in the tooth fairy. But then one day I grew up and I realized that Santa Claus doesn't exist. I realized that the tooth fairy doesn't exist. And in the same manner, one day I grew up and I realized that God doesn't exist. I've always found that line of argumentation rather funny, because to me it seems completely absurd to say Santa Claus doesn't exist, because obviously Santa Claus exists. There are Santa Clauses everywhere at Christmas. There are guys who dress up as Santa Claus. There are Santa Claus decoration, ornaments, we have stories, we have songs, we have all these things which celebrate Santa Claus. It is patently absurd to say that Santa Claus does not exist. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. There are certain things that don't exist. For example, a square circle or dry water. Now, those things are impossible. They do not exist. But Santa Claus definitely exists. The question we need to ask is, in what manner does Santa Claus exist? And I think that asking oneself that question of how it is that Santa Claus exists can maybe help certain people understand the manner in which we say that God exists. There are things that exist that are not at the level of my coffee cup. There are things which exist at different levels of being. Obviously, Santa Claus exists, and you can say that about concepts. Love exists, but you can't. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. You can't put it in a bottle. You can't put it in a box, but it still exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. In a much more immediate manner than something like love. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. We know what Santa Claus looks like, what his purpose is. Now, the thing is that what people tend to struggle with is to understand that beings are not obvious. It's not that obvious how to contain a being. So you, for example, you have parts. You have hands and fingers, eyes, you have hair, you have all these different parts. And there is something, your being, your personhood, which holds all those things together. Now, Santa Claus is the same thing, but his body is just not as contained as your body. It is actually a lot bigger than your body. Parts of Santa Claus are the images of Santa Claus that we see in movies, that we see in stories, just like your picture, which appears online. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Your picture that's in your telephone or in some family album. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Is an extension of you. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. When people see the picture, they recognize you and they come into contact with you. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. So too, Santa Claus has parts. When a guy dresses up as Santa Claus in your mall, he is manifesting Santa Claus. He is a part of Santa Claus to the extent that he's participating in the being of Santa Claus at that moment. If a child goes to the mall, they sit on Santa Claus's lap, and then they speak to Santa Claus. What would you like for Christmas? The child will answer what they want for Christmas. And Santa Claus will find some story about how, you know, he's going to try to get that child his gifts for Christmas. So the child is speaking to Santa Claus. And that's really important to understand. The child is not speaking to Joe under the costume who put on the fake beard. She isn't speaking to him. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. She's speaking to Santa Claus. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. And it also isn't Joe that is answering. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. It's Santa Claus that is answering. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. it is obvious that Santa Claus exists. If Joe starts to tell the child something else, the child will no longer recognize Santa Claus. Joe will cease to be a body part of Santa Claus. Now, you can write a letter to Santa Claus, put it in the mail, send it to Santa Claus, and you know what? Santa Claus is going to answer. And it isn't Martha sitting in the post office, you know, typing out the letter. She's not the one who's actually answering. She is manifesting Santa Claus. The same thing you're doing to Santa Claus, I can do to you. When you answer my question, I can say, well, it's not you that is answering my question, right? It's your mouth that's answering my question. But is that true? Is it your mouth that's answering the question? No. Your mouth is the tool by which you are answering the question. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. The disguised Santa Clauses are the tool by which, obviously, Santa Claus exists. Santa Claus manifests himself in the world. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Santa Claus is a being that's pretty coherent. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. He has a personality. He has a way of speaking. You can engage with Santa Claus and Santa Claus will answer. This is not just imaginary, because you are not that contained as you think. You as a person, you can be possessed by all these different ideas. You can be influenced by all these external influences. And even in your mind, you are not as centered as you think. You have all these different kind of crazy personalities that can pull you in different directions. So why do you think that you as a person exists? Right? There is something. There is a total way in which those elements are pulled together into a consistent being. If it wasn't so, we'd say you're schizophrenic, or we'd say you're crazy. If you're not crazy, there's something pulling those elements together. So that when I ask you something, you answer me, I recognize you in that answer. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists. Obviously, Santa Claus exists.